here, it looks like this is not their first color analysis. They've gotten quite a few done already, but results seem to be inconclusive. Alright, no worries. I should be able to hopefully alleviate any confusion there. And reason. Fashion is very important to them, and they want to maintain an elegant and put-together appearance. Okay, yeah. I'll just circle that. Okay. Hi. Are you here for the color analysis appointment? Perfect, yeah. Yeah, come on in, welcome, sit down. Wonderful, okay. I'm just getting your notebook ready here. You will be going home with the full copy of the notes I take for you today on the colors that we select for you, that we figure out is your best fit. Do you have any questions for me before we begin? I know you said on the phone you've been through quite a few of these, so I just assumed you'll be ready to jump right in. Okay, awesome. No questions for me then. Can I get you anything to drink? We've got some sparkling water, some tea, some... That's very funny, the blood of your enemies. No, we don't have that. I'm just gonna place this paper around you if that's okay. We want to try to keep the colors as neutral as possible, as I'm sure you've noticed, because we don't want to detract from all the colors against your skin, okay? Lovely. Is it okay if I scoot in a little closer and place this on you? Thank you. I'll just tuck it around your collar, okay? Want to make sure Nothing tricks my eye. When it comes to the colors anyway. Okay. Is that comfortable? That's good. You just let me know if it's itchy or anything. I'm just making sure it's stuck perfectly into the collar all the way around there. I don't want it falling out in the middle. Okay, does that feel good? Doesn't feel like it's gonna fall off or anything. So I'm going to be holding a few different things up to your skin throughout this process. Just want to make sure you're okay with me coming in and out of your space throughout. I don't want to startle you or anything. Wonderful. So, typically first things first, I'm sure you're aware we're going to do the jewelry test. You're unfamiliar with that one. Well, that's a little odd, considering how many you said you've had, but the other consultants, they didn't do. Into the jewelry test with you. Interesting. Well, to each their own, I suppose. But it is very common to do a jewelry test where you hold different colors up to the skin tone to see which looks the best. So. I'll start with something like a gold. I like to pick a pretty thick chain, that way I can get a good idea of the color against your skin. No, I'm specifically looking for how the light of it plays with the light in your eyes, how it plays with the undertones of your skin, whether it brings out any typically seen as unsavory colors in your skin tone. The gold. I'll be honest, doesn't really seem to be doing you any favors. Okay. Do you typically wear a lot of gold? No, okay, that's okay. Well, then that must mean... that you wear a lot of silver. I'm sorry, did I startle you? Did you hiss at me? Okay. That's a new reaction. How about we don't do the silver then? Are you allergic by chance? You could say that. Oh, well, okay. I'm so sorry then. I will not, I won't touch you with the silver. Can I at least bring it? No. Okay. Very allergic then. Okay. That's totally fine. We can skip this step. I'll put it as far away as possible over here. So I'd just like to take some notes throughout, and again, you'll be going home with this notebook. So I'm just going to note that we were not able to complete the gold-silver test. Is that why he didn't do it with the others? That makes a lot more sense now. Again, I apologize. It might be worth mentioning in the future that you do have a silver allergy. That way that doesn't happen for you. Again, I would hate to have caused some sort of ill reaction for you. I will say, within the 5 seconds that I held it up there, it was strange. You know, the gold didn't really strike me as your color. I really thought silver was going to be it, and you were going to be a cool tone, but it almost seemed to zap the life from you. I've never seen anything quite like it, to be honest. Inconclusive, but there, no worries though. There's a few other ways I can check and see what your overall skin tone is. I will be honest, you do have a very unique complexion. I haven't quite seen one like it, but I welcome the challenge. Okay. Got that note in there. Normally, I've got some clips that I like to put in every individual's hair to kind of hold their hair back regardless of color. That way I can get a good idea of skin tone. Normally I do go ahead and use a color of clip that matches whichever jewelry tone looked best on them. So I'd have a gold or a silver, but since that was inconclusive, I've got these little black ones. Not typically the ones I would use, but they should work in a pinch. Is that okay? Black, metallic, clip, okay. You do like black. Alright, well, wonderful. Let me just go ahead and get these clipped in your hair, if that's alright. Okay. Okay. I just really want to get the hair out of your face. Thank you. say you have a very unusual eye color. It's part of my job to really look at the eye color and figure out what would match it best. That's not one I've seen, is that? Like there's flecks of orange and red in them almost. It's quite striking. Very unique. That's not contacts? No, okay. That is it. That is very unique. Have I always been this color? Not always. When did they start changing? Several hundred years ago. That's a good one. Okay. It's okay if you don't want to tell me. I'll just... So, I do always like to ask people what they think their eye color is. So, what would you say yours is? That's an interesting choice. Okay. Right. Color of destruction. That was the word choice. You know, I was going for like a blue or brown. Or in your case, an orange, I guess. Not really like an essay title or something, but you know what? If that is what floats your boat, who am I to tell you not? The color of destruction. Orange. Well, if you wouldn't mind, could you just close your eyes for me? I want to see the veins there behind the eyelid. Are you feeling okay? You can open. I do not mean to sound rude or anything. Are you sick with anything, perchance? The veins on your eyelid are very pronounced to an extreme degree that is slightly worrisome. It's a congenital. Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, okay, that's too bad then. I apologize, I didn't mean to be in insensitive or anything. I just, if I didn't know that's what was going on, that would be a concern. I'm sorry. We'll move on. Could you give me your hand? Going to be looking at the veins on your wrist here. Could I have your other one? Thank you. You know, you can have your hands back. Again, I would hate to be insensitive. Your wrists. Is that part of the congenital thing? Well, no, it's just that there's absolutely no. Your veins are practically non-existent. I don't really know what's going on there. Your hands are very Would you like me to get you a blanket or anything? Are you sure? Okay. Seriously, let me know if you want a hot beverage or anything. Okay, well, I can't exactly type your undertone based off of the normal things. You are an enigma, my friend. Okay, so I can't do the silver. Can't really use the eyelids. You have like no veins in your wrists. What is another way that I could figure out your skin tone? Hands one more time. Thank you. Check the nail beds. Have you ever, crazy question. Have you ever gotten frostbite on your fingertips? You haven't. You may want to have that looked at. The purple color on your fingertips, that's a little concerning. I'm no doctor, of course, but I would get that checked. Yeah, they do look severely as if they've been frostbitten. So, can't really use that to type your skin tone either. Okay, let's just move on to color, the fabric swatches, and I'll see if I can't just do it that way, okay? Yeah. Alright. Well, I do like to start with a fabric choice people tend to have very strong opinions on. Start with yellow. What was that? Nothing. It's funny, just like sure you hissed at me again. Okay, so I have two neutral yellows here, and then three more pigmented yellows. So we'll start with the neutrals just to give you kind of a base idea of what we're looking. So the rest of this process, as I'm sure you're aware, is going to be taking two fabric swatches and holding them up to your face, checking for any lightness it brings to your skin, your eyes, anything like that, okay? Now this one, if you can't guess, I'm going to scoot it a little closer. So this one, cool tone. And this one, this is our warm tone. So I'm going to be holding them up to you one at a time and just kind of looking everywhere, especially at your eyes, underneath the eyes, around the nose, seeing what colors it brings out in the undertones of your skin. How do you feel about the color yellow? You despise it because it reminds you of sunshine. That is a unique take that I have not heard before. I don't quite understand the hatred for it. I do. I wouldn't exactly say yellow is your color, that's for sure. Definitely washes you out a bit more, if that's even possible. You do have a very pale isn't even the right word. Sallow, I think is the correct term. Complexion, it just really seems... It seems like there is absolutely no pink in your skin. So that's a unique thing to work with, trying to get your colors picked out here. Yellow. These aren't... Neither one's really doing it for you, are they? Let me move on to the more pigmented ones. You know, once we've figured out if you're cooler or warm, then typically we go into, a winter, a summer, a spring, an autumn, and then from there we would pick out whether you were a light, a soft, or a deep of whichever season. And you know, sometimes you could have a yellow in your season but not in your depth, if that makes sense. So maybe it's just not in your depth. We'll set these aside for now. So let's look at these now. So just like the last time, we've got a cool yellow. That really just does you absolutely no favors, doesn't it? I'm gonna hold it up right by your eye here. Yeah, that. I absolutely do not mean to be rude or anything, but that looks utterly terrible on you. Okay. Move on to the next one. As with most things that I will be doing today, if I tell you that a color looks good or bad on you, and it happens to be a color that you feel particularly strong about in one way or another, it's totally fine if you disregard me, in my opinion. If you love it and I say it doesn't look good, then you love it, you should wear it. If you hate it and I say it looks great, then don't wear it. Do whatever makes you feel happy with the colors, okay? For example, I am either a soft summer or a deep summer. Which means I have a cool undertone, but silver is recommended for me. But I prefer gold, so I wear gold because it makes me happy. So you do whatever makes you happy, okay? This is the trick here. I've got a neutral yellow. That's just not doing it either, is it? It really just sucks the life out of you, doesn't it? The warm yellow. Dare I say that's the worst one of all so far. Oh man, this is a challenge. Okay, we're gonna put the yellows away. Those just don't seem to be in your wheelhouse at all. after yellow I would do an orange test, but I get the feeling, yeah, orange doesn't seem like your color either. Why don't I try greens? Let's do that. So these are fairly bright greens. Again, we have a cool, a neutral, and a warm. Yeah, our cool tone. I mean, it's better than the yellow. It's definitely better than the yellow. Doesn't quite bring the life to your eyes that I was hoping for, you know? Let's try the neutral green. This is a very slight difference, but you can see it a little bit. No, not that one either. Okay, well. Interesting. Why don't I try some deep colors? Maybe you're at the deep winter or the deep autumn or something like that. So these are still in the green family. A warm and a cool. Okay. Okay, so that looks a little bit better. It does contrast nicely with the orange in your eyes. It still just doesn't. It doesn't have that pizzazz. Maybe not the absolute best color that we could possibly find, but it's definitely better than the others, that's for sure. I think deeper, dark gem tones might be the way to go for you. And so far, this dark green is the best one, so I think we're gonna go down that path for a little bit and see what that does for us. Yeah. Okay, let me just make some notes on what we've gone through so far. Okay, and then the greens were also grays, but grays can have a warm and a cool tone. So I'm gonna hold up a warm and a cool toned gray to you and see which one looks better and see if that helps me out a bit, okay? Perfect. Okay, so if I didn't know any better, I'd say that this was maybe just a shade or two darker than your skin tone. That is wild. So I wouldn't wear the grays because they wash you out, because they match you so well. Trick that normally helps me figure it out. Is it possible that we discovered a new undertone? Possible that you have a gray undertone? Okay. Just out of curiosity. You're somehow just as pale as this. Well, this is your undertone. I don't understand. Okay, let me try something else. Let's just go to the opposite end of the spectrum here. Oh. Oh my. Black actually looks fabulous on you. What on earth? And normally, we tell people that yes, black is a neutral. Should be careful because not many people can pull it off but you. Dare I say, black is your color. Black is absolutely your color. Okay, we are back in business here. Wow, that looks incredible on you. You wear a lot of black. You do. Well, I mean, it works. It works marvelously. Funny, if I didn't know any better, I'd say your skin was almost sparkling with how much it's illuminating it. Wild. Okay, yeah, no, that makes your eyes pop. It's like some life has been brought back into your skin. Wow, okay, so black is a really good color. Fascinating. Interesting test subject. Okay. snatched your undertone. White. Blended in a little too well. Skip the light blues. I feel like the light blues would wash you out too much. Yeah, they almost get this bruised effect as if you haven't been sleeping in ages underneath your eyes. So we're just gonna skip all of those. I'm gonna skip the light purples too, because I think the same thing is gonna happen. Yeah, these different. Just aren't it, but they think. Circle.